This week, Reactions is on the road. We're in West Orange, New Jersey, at the laboratory of one of the greatest inventors of all time, Thomas Edison. Edison recognized the value of chemistry in almost all of his inventions, and a lot of it happened right here.
The Thomas Edison National Historical Park is practically a giant time capsule. Inside its many buildings are more than 400,000 items dating back to the 1880s. But it's not just the artifacts that make it amazing. It's also a template for modern research and development laboratories everywhere. The West Orange facility was state-of-the-art when it opened in 1887, and Edison's idea was to make it a one-stop shop.
You have all that you need here. You have your chemists, you have your machinists, you have your physicists, you have people who know about electronics. And if you're interested in those, getting into those areas, you've got that expertise here.
Edison was particularly interested in chemistry. Not only did he build a giant facility for chemical research, he had his own private laboratory in another building. His love dates back to the experiments of his childhood.
He was always a chemist. He started as a young child. He had a chemistry lab in his bedroom until a certain accident. His mother sent him to the basement. He had a chemistry lab on the train that he worked on. So he always valued chemistry in many, many different forms.
From batteries to rubber to recorded music, chemistry was at the heart of many of Edison's world-changing inventions. His phonograph records evolved from an etching on tinfoil to wax cylinders.
He experimented with many different kinds of waxes and eventually came up with a number of very hard waxes, black waxes, as well as a blue amberol wax that he eventually commercialized a number of cylinders with.
Eventually, Edison settled on the more popular disc shape and used various polymers and resins to coat a wooden core. These records were easily mass-produced and highly durable, which was particularly useful for the portable phonographs sold by the Edison Company. Edison's phonographs were the first devices able to reproduce recorded sound. Thanks to Edison, you didn't need to see a live performance. You could get down to hot beats from Enrico Caruso, the Fisk Jubilee Singers, and the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. And where would portable music players be these days without a good battery? Guess who helped usher in the modern battery? In 1900, Edison set out to produce an alternative to the batteries of the day.
Lead acid batteries at the time were heavy, they were expensive, they would spill acid all over the place. He was looking for a different variant on that.
Edison put 9 years worth of work into battery research, dealing with laboratory and commercial failures along the way. Eventually, the Edison storage battery emerged from West Orange in 1909, using a nickel-iron alkaline system that is a precursor to the modern lithium-ion batteries like the one in the phone you might be watching this on.
If you look at your cell phone, there are a number of components or features to it that could be traced back to Edison. It's got a light in it, obviously from Edison. It's got a voice transmitter. It's got recorded music on it, obviously the phonograph. Itself. It's got images on it. The motion picture camera goes back to Edison as well.
And many of those ideas started here in West Orange. That incomparable facility is now a National Historic Chemical Landmark.
It's not only a commemoration of Edison and his efforts, but it also highlights the need for innovation and invention. He had tremendous impact on the course of human history. And people should be inspired when they come here to do the same thing.
Hopefully this video at least inspired you to hit the subscribe button. For more history, check out our video on 5 black chemists who changed the world. And if you're into inventions, why not check out how artificial snow is made? Thanks for watching, and we're back next week with more chemistry fun and facts.